I could not be there today. We have our engineering open house and hosting a party of 60 graduate students tonight and recruiting them. And so for that reason, I did it by Zoom, and from sitting here in the mountains of Virginia, speaking to you, I presume, in the mountains of West Virginia, I want to talk a little bit about my career and sort of some parallels it has with the famous Ibsen play, Enemy of the People. And I'm kind of subtitling this some reflections on my own career of cowardice and conformity. And just as some background, Ibsen's play, Enemy of the People, it's now more than 160 years old. And it tells the story of a medical doctor, Stockman, who discovers that the town bath and resort's been contaminated and it's causing people to get sick. And when this doctor rightly tries to alert the public and announces discovery, first he's ignored and then he's attacked. And he refused to do that. He refused to back down, and he was, of course, denounced as a lunatic and enemy of the people. And this play is timeless. It's currently being made into a Broadway play for a lot of reasons, but first and foremost, it tells us a truth, and that is science will be corrupted if ever government interests are in conflict with public health goals and private property rights. And my career has unfortunately proven that to be the case. I started out as a PhD in 1990, and around that time, we're running off the triumph of cleaning up drinking water and moving sewage out of cities, which was one of the greatest engineering achievements of the 20th century. And we were advancing and moving into considering what happens to that water after it leaves the treatment plant. And of course, what we know, it goes on a journey that could be hours, could be days, could be weeks, of through concrete pipe, iron pipe, eventually getting to a house where there's a service lateral made of copper, lead, or plastic, and then goes into the house. And my PhD was spent looking at, maybe we should protect the water in that part of the journey as well, because a lot of bad things could happen to it. And then, in my first job as an engineer, I had a stunning realization, something that became my life's work, and that was realizing that there was a gap to the tap. Specifically, what happens to the water after it goes across that property line into home plumbing and it encounters a hot water system and a cold water system and all kinds of other issues. And that led me to start studying what I now call the three L's of building plumbing, looking at things like Legionella, which grows in warm water systems of buildings, and other pathogens that can harm us, kill us, leaks, and the infrastructure damage that occurs if you have corrosive water, and then also looking at things like lead and other contaminants that leach to the water. So these are my three L's that I've been studying and kind of pioneering this new frontier of water safety. And my career in this regard was going great, and I loved it. I had great students, and but I didn't know the history of this problem, and it's a long one, especially when it comes to lead. And I'll tell you a little bit about it right now, that this is a government conflict of interest. Those lead service lines that are used to connect homes to the main water system were there because lead is a very great plumbing material. It's actually the best material known to humankind. It's inexpensive, except for the fact that since Roman days, we know that it makes people ill and kills people. because of its incredibly good longevity, though, and it's so easy to install, it was actually the law that in many American cities, if you wanted to connect your house to a water main, you had to use a lead pipe. And this is an ad from the National Geographic in 1923 extolling the virtues of that and bragging that that's actually the law. And so what you have is a problem, because these pipes are the moral and legal responsibility of the government. And in a great book that was written about 1990 on this issue, a historian looked at this and considered it to be one of the greatest environmental and public health disasters in U.S. history. He documented how many fetal deaths and miscarriages arose from installation of lead pipe, especially